Learning new expressions in French are a fantastic way to expand your vocabulary and sound more fluent, sound more French even to the French. Today we're going to talk about family expressions in French. The goal of today's lesson is easy. Learn five new expressions in French about the family, and you're going to learn how to use them because so often students learn expressions that they don't actually know how to use. So we'll cover both today. As usual, you can download the full written lesson on commeinfrançaise.com. Just go to the blog post by following the link below the video if you're watching this on YouTube, and leave your first name and email and you will get the full written lesson in PDF right away for free. You can take notes, print it, send it to your friends, whatever you like, and keep it forever. Bonjour, c'est Géraldine, bienvenue sur Comme une Française. Allez, c'est parti. Un air de famille. Un air de famille is an expression that is pretty easy to understand. That means une ressemblance. Une ressemblance, okay? A likeness, for example. Une ressemblance, that's un air de famille. When you look at people, you think they look like they're from the same family. That's un air de famille. For example, avec leurs cheveux bouclés, on voit bien qu'il y a un air de famille entre Michel et Barbara. Avec leurs cheveux bouclés, on voit bien qu'il y a un air de famille entre Michel et Barbara. If you want more on the family and how to talk about your relatives, I made another lesson on this topic. It's called Family Matters, French Words to Talk About Your Loved Ones. You will find the link somewhere and mostly on the blog post on Comme une Française. Don't miss it. It's very useful to be able to talk about your family properly in French. Laver son linge sale en famille. Laver son linge sale en famille. It means in French, to wash your dirty laundry in family. So, and a synonym that we could say is régler ses problèmes privés en privé. Régler ses problèmes privés en privé. I think in English you have an equivalent, to refrain from airing your dirty laundry in public. I think that's the equivalent. Well, in French we say laver son linge sale en famille. Laver son linge sale en famille, literally to wash your dirty laundry within your family. For example, how can we use that? It's very easy. Pierre n'aurait pas dû parler à tous ses voisins de ses problèmes d'héritage. Il vaut mieux laver son linge sale en famille. Pierre n'aurait pas dû parler à tous ses voisins de ses problèmes d'héritage. Il vaut mieux laver son linge sale en famille. Pierre shouldn't have told all his neighbors about his inheritance issues. It's better to laver son linge sale en famille. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. Or, il ne faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. As you might know, in everyday spoken French, we cut some elements of grammar, words. Here we don't say il ne, we say just faut pas, okay? It means you should not push grandma into the stinging nettles. I think that's how you translate les orties. Les orties is this plant that hurts when you touch it. Les orties, it's stinging nettle. It's not literal. We don't say don't push your grandma in the stinging nettle because that's pretty obvious, but it's an expression that means don't push it. Il ne faut pas exagérer. Il ne faut pas exagérer. Here, just like, as I said before, you could say faut pas exagérer. Faut pas exagérer and remove the beginning. So this means don't push it. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. It's such a funny expression that honestly it's used a lot on t-shirts as well. There are lots of references about that because even French people realize how ridiculous this expression sounds. Let's take an example now. Je veux bien t'aider à choisir ta robe de mariée, mais je ne vais pas la payer. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. Je veux bien t'aider à choisir ta robe de mariée, mais je ne vais pas la payer. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. I'm okay to help you choose your wedding dress, but I'm not going to pay for it. Don't push it. Prudence est mère de sûreté. Prudence est mère de sûreté. It's the complete opposite of faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties in terms of fun. Prudence est mère de sûreté is so much more formal. It's a very wise proverb, as we say in French. We say un proverbe. The translation is better safe than sorry. And if you know this expression in English, you might know that we have another translation in French, which is mieux vaut prévenir que guérir. Mieux vaut prévenir que guérir. Okay? So it literally means it's better to be safe than to have to heal the situation. So it's better safe than sorry. So you can use one, prudence est mère de sûreté, which is a very elegant formal French, or you can use mieux vaut prévenir que guérir, which is okay as well. It's not in any way familiar, but it's more everyday. So use one or the other. Prudence est mère de sûreté. For example, Hélène devrait emporter son passeport et sa carte d'identité en voyage. Prudence est mère de sûreté. Hélène devrait emporter son passeport et sa carte d'identité en voyage. Prudence est mère de sûreté. Helen should take with her passport and her ID when she's going to travel because better safe than sorry. Un oncle d'Amérique. Un oncle d'Amérique. This one is a bit more tricky to understand because it's not literal and it doesn't have a proper translation in English. Un oncle d'Amérique is not l'oncle Sam. L'oncle Sam, which I think you probably know in the US as Uncle Sam, in the French culture represents the US, okay? That's an expression we have to talk about the United States of America in the press or in everyday language. That's just one of the names of the US, l'oncle Sam. This has nothing to do with it because it doesn't necessarily relate to the United States. We have this image of the lucky explorer going to the US and finding gold and coming back and being rich, but then it's moved on to other things. According to Le Grand Robert de la langue française, which is one of the reference dictionaries in French, un oncle d'Amérique is le parent riche émigré depuis longtemps qui apporte au sien un héritage inattendu. Le parent riche émigré depuis longtemps qui apporte au sien un héritage inattendu. So it means the rich parent, it's family-wise, it doesn't have to be your dad or your mom, who emigrated a long time ago and who brings back to his family a big inheritance. So as you can see, it's not related to the US, it's just an expression we have. From there, it can be two things. It can be a person, which is a rich person who can help you solve a financial issue in an unexpected way. So someone with lots of money, unexpected. Or it can be the money itself that we give this name to. It can be an unexpected amount of money that we don't know where it really comes from, is unexpected and helps you a lot. Okay, so it's ambiguous. This is why I wanted to leave it to the end. And it's okay if you don't get it. It's mostly for advanced students. But remember that un oncle d'Amérique is not someone who actually lives or lived in the US. It has nothing to do with it. It's the idea of unexpected amount of money that helps you. For example, je me demande comment Jeanne a fait pour récolter autant d'argent au sein de sa famille pour acheter sa maison. Un oncle d'Amérique, sans doute. Je me demande comment Jeanne a fait pour récolter autant d'argent au sein de sa famille pour acheter sa maison. Un oncle d'Amérique, sans doute. I wonder how Jeanne did to gather so much money in her family to buy her house. Probably un oncle d'Amérique. Okay, let's test yourself with a little quiz. How would you say mieux vaut prévenir que guérir? It's a synonym expression. Mieux vaut prévenir que guérir, which is better safe than sorry. How would you say in another way, il ne faut pas exagérer? Il ne faut pas exagérer. And at last, how would you say with an expression, ils se ressemblent, on dirait qu'ils sont de la même famille. Ils se ressemblent, on dirait qu'ils sont de la même famille. Well, what do you think? Mieux vaut prévenir que guérir, we say prudence est mère de sûreté. Prudence est mère de sûreté. Il ne faut pas exagérer. We have a fun expression for that. We say faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. Faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties. Remember this one? It's a funny one. About the fact that they look like each other, ils ont un air de famille. Ils ont un air de famille. They look like their family. Et toi, quelle est ton expression préférée parmi ces cinq-là? Quelle est ton expression préférée parmi ces cinq-là? Tell me in the comments below the video, especially on commentfrançaise.com. I read all the comments. For example, you can say in French, j'aime bien, faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties, car elle me fait rire. J'aime bien, faut pas pousser mémé dans les orties, car elle me fait rire. If you like this lesson today, please share it with your friends. It's the best way to support my work on Comme une Française. If you're watching this on YouTube, it would be very nice if you could, like, put a thumb up, subscribe to the channel on YouTube so you don't miss any episode, share it on Twitter, on Facebook, by email, or telling your French class about this lesson. Other students might like it as well. If you want more spoken French, you can go to commeunefrançaise.com and subscribe to get my 10-day everyday French crash course. It's a completely free 10-day mini course by email. You can subscribe anytime, unsubscribe anytime if you don't like it. It is completely free. I wish you une bonne journée, une bonne soirée. Maybe une bonne nuit if it's very late. And I will see you next time. Allez, salut!